Rutke and Mods.
Hello, I'm Greg Rutke of Rutke Mods, and welcome to episode 8 of season 2 of my Mac Pro series. In this episode, we're going to be addressing the security update for El Capitan that broke the 1.1, 2.1 Mac Pros. We're going to be explaining about it and how it happens, why it happens, and other things like, for instance, how to stop it from updating and how to recover from it. And all these things will be in the description, time-coded, if I remember to do it anyway. Well, anyway, let's go through the scenario here. Let's say you have the App Store update and the little red notification on the thing, and you decide, well, let's update to the latest security update without knowing what will happen. Well, if you update to that, your Mac Pro, just like this one right here, if it's a 1.1, 2.1, will become a very heavy, very useless aluminum brick. And you might as well just toss it away, right? I'm not going to throw that. That's actually my 3.1. Well, no. There's ways to recover from it. You haven't lost all your data yet, at least. And basically, I'm going to be showing you how to fix that. And it's not too hard, but it will take time. And if you end up exhausting all your ways, like I said, you haven't lost your data and you can recover it and won't be going all over that. So let's go. All right, so we're going to start off by recording this off of my iMac. It's right now running off of my MacBook through target disk mode. And I'm only doing this so we can get a good screen capture of this. Everything I'm going to do will apply to the 1.1, 2.1 Mac Pros and anyone who just doesn't want to get the next update. This update wasn't very important, In fact, it wasn't really important at all for the 1.1, 2.1. You do not need this update. So I'm going to be showing you how to block this update. And we're going to be doing it on this. Now, it's a very easy to block update. And you can still get all the updates that don't apply to it. This update was required for all CPUs that were supported by El Capitan. But since Apple doesn't officially support the 1.1, 2.1, there isn't an update for it. And now El Capitan, from what I can tell, is checking for supported CPUs. If your CPU is not on the list, this is what happens. You'll start booting up, and all of a sudden the screen will pop up as the loading screen, as it usually does, and then the system screen will go black and it will just reset itself. And that's because of the update. Basically, the operating system is protecting itself from unauthorized use. If your CPU is not supported, it will not work. It will red flag it and the operating system will just shut off. The system will reset. So, this system update is not needed, and we're not going to be putting it on. So, what we're going to do to fix that is to, first, let's open up the App Store here. And then we'll go over to the updates. And then we'll have the update here. Now, to block this update, but still be able to install the other updates, we'll go to More. And then we'll go down to the Security Update right here. Now, to block this update, we just have to right-click and hit Hide Update. And then the update will disappear, and it's gone. Now we can still use all the other updates. Everything else will still update. Your system will still stay secure enough without this update. Like, for instance, the update wouldn't have helped anyway. So your system will still be secure, and you'll still be able to install these updates. So before we install them, though, what I like to do is to close out the App Store, make sure it's completely closed, and then even reset the system. I'm going to restart the system just to show you what will happen, and that's just to make sure it will not install this update. So we're going to restart the system, and we'll be right back. Okay, so since we've restarted the system now, we can actually, in fact, since this system, my MacBook, this is running off of, can't support High Sierra, I'm going to hide this. But anyway, now if we go over here and we click more just to verify the update's still hidden, we'll see that there is no update now. And so what we're going to do is we can just hit update all and hit download restart, and it will update everything that it needs to update, and it will still be secure. All your other updates will still work, and your system will boot up like normal. So that's a good thing, and now you don't have to worry about it. But let's say you now have, let's say you've updated, and you need to, you know, recover from it. We're going to do that in the next step. This is the end of the screen capture, the really good production quality part. So sorry about that. But yeah, let's start filming the screen and getting everything set. So let's go. Okay, so here's the boot menu of my Mac Pro 2.1. Now, we're going to go over the very first way you can do it, the easiest way to do it, and the way I did it to recover my system. And the way I did it to recover my system involves using the recovery partition for El Capitan. But this will also work on Lion's recovery partition if you only have that. And the way I did this, see, I tested it to see if it really was true, and it took almost a day to restore my whole system. But this is how I did it. This is the easiest way to do it. And what we're going to do is we're going to go over and boot into the recovery drive. And what we're going to be doing is recovering from a time capsule backup. Now, if you don't have a time capsule backup, you might as well just skip this part of the video. But I'm going to show you how to do it with the time capsule backup. This, like I said before, will also work in Lion's restore, and it works the same way, the Lion recovery drive. So what we're going to do is have it boot up, and then we're going to sync it over to my backup and take it from there. Okay, so now we're going to go to Restore from Time Machine Backup. We'll hit continue, and then continue. Then we select this, hit connect, and basically what will happen is, let me put my password in here. What it will do is it will load all of the backups, and you'll find your backup, and you'll just restore it. And let's see here. My backup would be right, where is it? Twisted Mac, right there. Would hit continue. It starts loading up the Time Machine backup. We'll let this load up for a second. This might take a long time depending how big your backup is. Okay, so now we pick our El Capitan backups, and we'd restore it to the most recent backup we had where it worked. We'd hit continue, and then we'd choose the drive, which would be my El Capitan drive. We'd click restore, and it would ask if I'd like to wipe the drive. Everything would be lost. Well, if you're restoring from the time capsule backup, the time machine backup, it's not going to matter. You'll wipe the drive, it will restore everything back to the way it was, and then you can go over and follow the beginning of this video on how to block the update for future use. But there's other ways. Let's say you don't have a time capsule backup. Well, in this case, you'd have to get creative. And when I say you'll have to get creative, you may have to do what I'm about to explain to you. What I'd explain to you is you'll have to take the system, and since it's a Mac Pro, you can do this with no problems. What you would do is you would install an image of El Capitan on a secondary drive and leave your main drive alone. And when you take it and install it on there, like for instance, if you use my backup image, you could do that. Or let's say you'll have a restore drive. If you don't have a recovery drive, you'd have to do this also. But what you'd do is you'd load the image up onto another drive, get it running, and then you'd have to use Migration Assistant to move all your files from your main drive to that system's drive. And then that could become your main drive, or you can go and this is where it gets very time consuming, but you could wipe your main drive and then put an image back on the main drive and then migrate everything back over to that main drive. It will take a long time, but that's your other option if you don't have any other way to do it. Now, you may have to boot your system into, for instance, a target disk system if you don't have a Lion partition to do this. And basically, you'd have to follow episode 4 of season 1 to do that. It explains exactly how to do it. Just follow that and you'd be all good. Now, if you want to, if you need an image, episode 32 of last season, season 1, also has the image on it. And of course, all the warnings. I also have links, which I'll have in the description for this video, and also links in episode 7 and that episode 32 of last season. I have a link which sends you to a Apple website where you can download the most recent working security update, which was 2017-005 or something like that. That is the most recent update that works on these systems. So if you want to update my image or any image you have to the most recent security update, you just use that installer. It works like it would work on any other Mac, and you'll have no problems. So anyway, that's basically how you can recover this system if you've messed it up with the security update. And like I've said in the past, just don't update. That would be the quickest and easiest way to save your system. So anyway, that's the end of this video, and thank you for watching. By the way, I do have a Patreon now, so if you would like to help me out some, I'll have a link at the end of this video. And, you know, if you want to support me, go ahead. I'd greatly appreciate it. This has been a Rutke Mods video.